The concept of life has troubled yet fascinated humans since our existence. If you take a quick walk out to your backyard, it doesn't take you long to realise the myriad of living organisms we are surrounded by, each with varying complexity. From our furry best friends to the thousands of microorganisms inhabiting our mouth, we see the true beauty of life and all of its different shapes and forms, collectively playing their sound in the orchestra of life. It's truly remarkable. Among the many differences we see across varying life forms, a key similarity is seen when comparing complex, multicellular organisms, such as ourselves, to the simplest of life forms. We all utilise cell division as a means of reproduction and growth. And so, by observing the process of cell division in a vast array of organisms, both unicellular and multicellular, it is obvious it's extremely important and should therefore be a very organised, faultless process. Thus, there must be some sort of mediator or controlling factor present in cells as they undergo the cell cycle, right? Because without some sort of control, cells would have some difficulty proceeding through cell division. Well, as scientists have only recently discovered, this is actually true. One of the key mediators of the cell cycle are cyclins, discovered by Tim Hunt and a team of other scientists in 1983. The group, with focus on the eggs of three sea organisms, carried out a series of experimental procedures in order to determine protein synthesis of eggs following fertilisation or activation with parthenogenetic treatments, which in both cases activate DNA and protein synthesis. The first, most striking finding of the group was seen when comparing patterns of protein synthesis in unfertilised, fertilised, and parthenogenetically treated Arabaceae eggs. Following activation by fertilisation or treatment of calcium ionophore, the appearance of prominent new bands was observed. While some bands appeared after activation and showed a relatively constant prominence, the group found an even more interesting feature of protein synthesis of one of the newly synthesised proteins, a protein appropriately termed cyclin henceforth. Rather than showing continuous, consistent synthesis, cyclin showed relatively strong synthesis at early times after fertilisation, though at certain points of the cell cycle, cyclin appeared to disappear and then reappear at other times. In comparison to those showing a relatively constant synthesis throughout the cell cycle, the protein cyclin showed a cycling pattern throughout. But what was really going on? Through correlation of the oscillations observed in the level of cyclin with the cleavage cycle of embryos, it became evident that cyclin was being destroyed periodically at a certain point during the cell cycle. And so, the group hypothesized that this bizarre pattern showed by cyclin was due to its continuous synthesis coupled with its periodic destruction. To test this hypothesis, an experimental approach was used to compare protein synthesis with continuous labelling of embryos with pulse-labelled embryos. Whilst continuous labelling showed the usual cyclical pattern, observation of pulse-labelling experiments showed cyclin synthesis essentially constant throughout the cell cycle. The group believed that because there was no cyclical pattern in the pulse-labelled embryos, cyclin must participate in some type of maturation or assembly process before being destroyed. The characteristics of cyclin synthesis and synthesis of other proteins that remains constant following activation are analogous to an orchestra. Let's call it the orchestra of life. Following the conductor's signal, or cellular activation, members of the band begin to play. In other words, synthesis of new proteins begins. While some members, such as the percussion, play throughout the entirety of the song, proteins that show constant synthesis throughout the cell cycle, others play during certain parts of the song, such as those playing strings or woodwinds. These are representative of cyclin. Collectively, the members of the band, all newly synthesized proteins, play an important role in building up to the climax and completion of the song, the division of the cell. Unfortunately, Tim Hunt and his team were unable to provide sufficient, direct evidence proving a connection between the behaviour of cyclins and the processes involved in cell division. It turns out they were actually spot on. Their experimental findings laid the foundations for what we know about cyclin and its role in mediating the cell cycle, working as the cell's clock. Without cyclin, cells would be unable to know when to progress into the cell cycle and would never divide. It is now understood that cyclin's role in the cell cycle is quite a complex process. We'll save that for another day.